Well, I have some good news and I have some bad news. But like always, you just want the bad news. Why? And if you really want the deep doom and gloom, there is other channels out there that are woof. It's all doom, all gloom, all the time. They're real. I kind of chuckle about it, but prepare for an economic nightmare. Thank you, Atlantis Report. But you came here because you wanted to see what is going on with all the defunding everywhere and good old Los Angeles. I mean, you thought it was bad getting a cop a year ago? Forget it now. Los Angeles is so broke, we can't even afford S's here. Let me help you guys out there. Why is it the S's end up going and nothing else? Maybe S's sell really well in the aftermarket. Yes, this makes perfect sense. Cities all over America are slashing police budgets as what? Crime rates soar. Yeah, it's kind of like, too, you know, with everyone hates attorneys, hates lawyers, you name it. There's a lawyer joke in every pocket until you need one. And as you can see in this report, if violent crime rates are surging, should the police get more funding or less funding? I think the answer is less, right? That just makes complete sense. And the criminals in my area are having a field day. And these the percentages are just staggering, like up 450%. Actually, carjacking, I was off by about 100%. Carjacking is up 537%. Carjacking. So that's a thing. Okay. Meanwhile, homicides are up 60% this year. I mean, it is a flustercluck all over. It looks like Seattle is not a place that you want to move to anytime soon, unless you live there and you're trying to get out. Let's see, we got murders are up, highest level since 2008. Last year, the Trouble City is also suffering a spike. Suffering. It's when you, I don't even know. Why would you suffer? A spike in violent crime with 8,418 burglary incidents, up from 7,000 last year, according to the police. And I have a lot of police officer friends because I used to work law enforcement. My little radar gun. And then I'd never write tickets. Like, oh, you cried? Ah, you're all right. Just move along. And actually, believe it or not, I applied for LAPD. I got a 98 out of 100. And they said it wasn't high enough. Needed to be 100. And all of my police friends are like, dude, you are so fortunate. I mean, they are miserable. Just to let you guys know, for those of you that just hate the police, they hate their jobs too, okay? And all my cop friends are really nice. You're like, have you ever been harassed? Oh, yeah, I've been harassed. I've been thrown on top of cop cars. Go through high school. Oh, I was that kid, right? I had the lowered mini truck, rap music. It was not a good thing. Honest to goodness, I was pulled over once a week when I was in high school. It wasn't a day that didn't go by that I didn't. I had the black limo tint all around. I've been searched more times just in high school than I have going through airport security over my lifetime. So let's listen in and see what ABC has to say about everything that's being cut. And then I'll give you some little secret tidbits. Because, you know, when you have friends.
New at 11, big budget cuts coming to the LAPD. And we just learned new information about the impact that will have on specialized police units. Some will be downsized, others completely disbanded. We've also learned current department vacancies will not be filled, and instead those positions within the LAPD will be eliminated in order to downsize the department to meet its new staffing goals. More staff reductions will occur through managed attrition.
All right. Perfect. So if you were ever thinking about getting a job as a police officer, well, you probably shouldn't. And I got some more for you. One of the girls that I follow on Instagram, cop, man, these girls are woo! They can shoot them guns fast. Like, woof. Let's see. Safer cities gone. I guess you're not going to have safer cities. These are either gone or drastically cut. Homeless outreach. Well, we got lots of that. I think they're trying to give that to someone else. Some like therapists. I was going to say parole officers. Someone else is supposed to be taken. And they're like, oh, we don't want to take that. So homeless outreach, burglary. Gone. So I guess you could just auto theft, animal cruelty. cats. It's gonna make a cat joke. Chose against it. Hollywood Entertainment, Pacific Area Beach Detail, University Park, robbery, homicide, commercial crimes, Metropolitan Traffic and Labor Relations Unit. And you know what they say? The path to hell is always paved with good intentions. Ivy League, this coming in from campus reform, because we need to reform our campuses. Let me zoom in on that. I know you're supposed to hit control and zoom. I'm bad. I guess she's a bad librarian. We'll just stop the jokes there. Ivy League librarians demand a world without policing. Let me just say this. What we need to do, we need to take you, okay, out of the library where everyone's like, shh, okay? Like people that go into libraries, they're quiet. They're just reading. They're little bookworms. You have no idea. Go work in the jails. You want to see what bad is? You want to see what evil is? Actually, go work in the jails, in the women's jails. That's really bad. Bad people will be bad people, right? These people could have, let's say, they're a sociopath or a psychopath where the part in their brain has no guilt. I mean, it's great. You can be a politician, not feel guilty. Do whatever you want. Control. They love the control. Money, nah, that's okay. That's like comes in a lower second to control. But you got these people that kill and they don't feel bad. They just do whatever they want. So a lot of times people, well, I would struggle with that. I'm like, how could you do that? Well, with psychopathy, it's a part of the brain that they don't feel bad. They're like, it's a game. They like playing the game. This is good. We'll just keep doing it. And then these people in the libraries are like, the problem is the police. I'm like, no, the problem is evil people in the world that need to be stopped. And what's sad is these people are in control. Oh, I'm a high school teacher, so I know. You can't even like say anything bad. Oh God, you guys, you don't even know. How I still have a job? All right. Thank you very much. But like this person, what, didn't wear a mask? It was Arizona. They didn't wear a mask. So now, you know, one kid. So now he has to, he was in a suit though. But now he has to go through personal workshops because he didn't wear a mask. And he has to pay fines and fees and violations. And you guys know this is even part of the tubes, man. They're just like silencing. That's, what is that? No, that's after you get busted. You're like, nope. That's I teach law too. Teach kids like the First Amendment. There's actually five in it. The Second Amendment, right? The Fifth Amendment. We're not going to talk. But that would be the numero uno. The email said that such behavior violated the student code of conduct. If you question, wearing the face diaper, in endangering. This is what happens when you don't do it. This is what you're going to be punished: threatening or causing harm to any member of the university community. I wonder if the police will be given extra funds though, for people like the don't wear a mask division, right? You're there like writing tickets all day. But here you go. I guess this kid spoke out, whatever, wrote something, maybe Instagram, like that. A few days after Orsay spoke to the university on September 19th, he received an email stating that he would receive a COVID-19 monetary sanction of $250. There you go. He was also forced to complete a personal responsibility workshop for an additional $90. And call me crazy, because I probably am. I feel like I'm the only one on this other side of the fence going like, hey guys, do you understand government and control and what is happening here? They're just like, ooh. And Biden, here we go, says he'll ask all Americans to wear a mask for 100 days. So there you go. There you have it. Rather than the, a president comes in, this is what I'm going to do. This is how I'm going to improve the economy with my 100-day plan. This 100-day plan is to make sure that you are wearing a surgical mask or whatever mask you guys decide to wear for 100 days, which I don't think that would improve the economy. I actually think that might hinder an economy. Just kind of go back and look. Look what's happened. And has it gotten better or worse with all the precautions? I swear people like swim in this. Hold on. Let me, you know, I remember that one time when I went to a restaurant, they had the mask, they had the face covering. And I guess someone even got it and they had to close the whole restaurant down forever. But here's what will close under a stay at home order. Well, just about everything. This is what's happening right now. Come on out. Come on to California. I always keep asking. See, I keep leaving. You guys can come in. Yeah, stay at my house. Restaurants will close. Gone. Both indoor, outdoor. You guys should see it in California. So they close the indoor. So then the restaurants are like, okay, well, we can do outdoor because the virus isn't out there. It's inside. So then they all go outside and they have tents. So they actually recreate an indoor but outdoor, but in the parking lot, which is, I'm sure, real safe. Oh, man. Granny's like, boop, boop. Oh, sorry. Didn't see you there. This is my normal handicap spot. And then she backs up. Boop, boop. Oh. There you are again. I see you waving down there. Let's see. What's it? Bars, wineries. Well, unless it's Newsom's winery, he gets to keep his open. That was pretty cool. Hair salons. Oh, what am I going to do? I got to get that Flowbee or something. Barbershops, nail salons. Looks like I'll be saving some money on that. My wife lives at those. Retail stores. Oh, great. You can have 20% open. Okay. So we're going to monitor you. And then private gatherings of any size. Any size. You want to gather, you know, with like two people? No, you can't do that. Except if they say it's in protest. So if you riot, that's okay. But if you hang out with your familia, that is not okay. But Johnny Bravo, didn't you see the jobs report? Like 6%, 7% unemployed? Oh, okay. Really? Really? You want? I'll show you the numbers. Hold on just a moment. Let me just tell you, when you do all of this, Southwest ramps up layoffs. Boom, gone. Almost 7,000 jobs, and that's just Southwest. I thought they weren't even cutting. And initial jobless claims, let me go ahead and Casper myself, over 700,000 initial jobs. I didn't even know there was anyone left to have initial jobless claims. Where have you guys been? People are like, oh, it's the initial jobless claims are down. Right. It's been a year and you guys are just finally deciding to go like, oh, lost my job. See, all these guys over back in here, they're all running out. And these guys are all new. So, guess it is what it is. But what you need to be looking at is this. This is the labor force participation rate. If you would like to download it, here we go. And see this? The trend is your friend. That was from 2000. Remember that little bubble pop all the way down and whoop down. And let's just zoom in so you can kind of see what I've been talking about. And this is what's happening. Look at this. Down, down, down. These are the people that are actually working. And they're not. And it fell and we're below it. And if we even zoom in more, you can see kind of what's happening here, right? Nope, no one, and then, oh, we're okay. No, we're, see this? No, it is the trend. And we had a huge miss in payrolls. Again, do you see the trend? Not good. Oh, you guys wanted to get paid? Eh, maybe in a few years from now. And coming in from CNBC, someone actually brings that to the attention that I'm talking about.
The one thing that we haven't heard is the labor force participation rate. And I think that's going to be critical in understanding the edge down in the unemployment rate. You can't just look at the unemployment rate because we know people are leaving the workforce and people are leaving. A lot of women are leaving the workforce because we're still in many places in lockdown mode when it comes to schools and childcare and health concerns.
Aha. You see? They can skew the numbers. People are not, they're leaving. They're not coming back in. They're like, bye. Like, oh, unemployment's 6%. Oh, really? Liar. And the bond. Oh no, everyone run over to Stephen Van Meter's channel. Make sure you subscribe. Make him, he just got another beating today. And Bitcoin, I'll be talking about that tomorrow. It has the Christmas pattern. It's so hard to try to like do technical analysis on Bitcoin. So we're going with the, we're shorting it based on the Christmas tree pattern that it is now dropped in the 18,000s. But that is not why you came here. You came here because of TLT. TLT, that is the bond that is way bigger than the stock market. And it'll kind of forecast for you. What is the stock market going to do? And it's, I think it's about four times bigger than the stock market. And I say I'm not jumping in until we get above that trend line. And we just had a beat down today, continuing to drop. I thought there was some hope, but we couldn't get above it. And your interest rates, are going up. So we will see. That is the bond. That is the 30-year treasury bond yield up. Taking a look at the rest of my portfolios, I was listening to Meet Kevin talk about some stocks. He said we'd do a little hangout together. Maybe we will see. But he said something very interesting because we both, our trading philosophies are different. He's your more so your buy and hold, and I am more so your swing trading. And he goes, yeah, all those swing traders are all like piling in, causing stocks. This is Snapchat, right? Why would I just want to buy and just and hold when I can make I don't know what percent more, but I'll show you. Like take for example Snapchat, and I do have a course on this. Link in the description. I think it's 300? Did it go up to 4 or 5? It's going up to 1,000. So whatever it is in the description, get it now before it hits 1,000. Which still I think 1,000's fine. But look at these swings. Like you sell, okay, and then it swings and you buy. It swings, you buy, you sell. You buy, you sell. You get it? I mean, yes, you can go, all right, I'll just randomly, you know, pick here to buy. And, you know, you make, what, 7%? Or you can make 4%, another 4, another 4, another 4. And just roll with the swings. And the more people that get into this whole swing, it's like, woo, and we get out. And woo, that's what it is when you're on a swing, right? It's kind of stupid when it just sits there, but when someone starts pushing you, oh, that is so much better. And Kevin was talking about Lemonade. This is the insurance company. Pretty cool, right? But and this, look at your swing. Oh, down and buy. And I mean, what is the gains on this? Why complain? Don't complain about it. And then when it starts to top off, you get out. Here to here, what are we looking at? Almost, yeah, 29, 30%. Okay. And then let that sell off. These are oversold conditions. Look in, let me pull this up so you can see it. Do you see this? This is when, yeah, right? You're getting out. You're taking your beans off of the table. And also when you figure this out, my police officer friends are like, dude, wait a minute. So I have to say, it's not financial advice. You'll lose all your money. Don't listen to anything that I say. Even on Amazon, don't start businesses. Everyone just fails. But you start figuring out, wait, so I can trade equities and I can make money if I know what I'm doing. And then I can, instead of being a police officer, I can sell something and stay home. And I just wanted to search, like, which one would you like? Police scanner. You can make a police scanner, police cars, police car toys for boys, police costume for kids, police toys. You could do a radar detector and Lego. You know, you guys know they lost their, copyright patent, all that on their little pieces. So you can make the fake ones. You just can't use the word Lego. But how much is this even a Lego? Look at this. If you were to sell a said, does this even say Lego in here? A friction powered police car. That is that. Nope. Visit the toy to enjoy store. Okay, no jokes on that one. The Toy to Enjoy store. I probably don't want to click on that one. Otherwise, we may get banned. So this guy's making $7,713 on this right here, right? $7,000 a month. It's like, why? Do I want to be a police officer and have people shoot at me? Or would I rather make a plastic friction-powered police car and maybe make two of them? And here's another little secret. You click on their store to go like, oh, what else are you selling that I could then sell, but I could make it better, right? Oh, so you sell a dump truck. okay, that's cool. So he also sells a dump truck. What do you make selling on the dump truck? And I don't know these numbers prior to clicking on it, so I did not cherry pick. Oh my gosh. Do you see my reaction? $76,000 selling a dump truck. I kid you not. And when people ask me, we're like, wait, how much you make on Amazon? What do you do on Amazon? Well, I'm not going to show you my products because I don't need you knocking my dump truck off. Because I got a big dump truck. But if this looks interesting, right? Because I try to help you guys. Like, I don't want to fight. I don't want to, like, stop this and stop that. Is start a business, trade equities. Link in the description. That one's $198. It's like 80-plus videos on how to do this. So take a look at it. Link in the description. And one more thing. From the bottom of my heart, I just want to say thank you guys so much for helping me get to that goal. That was a goal I had. Teaching high school kids, like 100,000. I'm like, I'll never get that. So I just want to say thank you for subscribing. If you have, if you haven't, well, you can always just think about it. And I will see you tomorrow.